How calculus teachers create integrals for a test?
So here's the solution to this integral that I created. And then the beauty of this is that, check this out, we have sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, cotangent. Everybody is here, and now let's see how to solve this. Check this out. First, right here, we have sine squared plus cosine squared, that's equal to what? That's just equal to 1, right? Very nice. And then if you look at 1 plus tangent squared, do you remember the identity? This is just secant squared. And if you want to work this out real quick, I'll show you. This is 1 plus, this is the same as sine squared over cosine squared. And then we can get a common denominator, which is just cosine squared. So we need that right here. Plus the sine squared. And this right here is, again, just equal to 1. 1 over cosine squared, we just get secant squared x. So in fact, this whole thing inside is just that. So here we go. This is really just the integral. And then we have 1 plus ln of secant squared x. And then raised to the pi's power. Yeah, to the pi power, why not? And of course, right here, the 2, the power, we can put that to the front of the natural log, right? So that's pretty much what we have. And then on the bottom, oh my God, we have a derivative and all that. But don't worry, just do this inside out. Check this out. Ln of cosecant plus ln of secant plus ln of cotangent. Plus, plus, we can just what? Multiply the inside. So we can just put them together as taking the derivative of ln of cosecant x times secant x times cotangent x. Yeah, and what's this though? Well, let's just work this out on the side. This is just 1 over sine for secant, for cosecant, and then for secant is 1 over cosine, and then this is cosine x over sine x. That's for cotangent. Cosine, cosine cancel. So really, we just have 1 over sine squared, right? So this right here is the same as ln of 1 over sine squared. And before we take the derivative, we can put this to the top and then write it as negative 2, right? So ln of sine x raised to the negative 2 power. And then before we take the derivative, use the natural log property, bring that to the front. So we get negative 2 ln of sine x. And then we do the derivative. Right, so that's what we have. And let's see how it looks like. So let's just focus on that right here real quick, yeah? So taking a derivative of negative 2, you just keep that. And then derivative of ln is 1 over that, so 1 over sine x. And then use the chain rule, multiply by the derivative of sine, which is cosine x. Cosine x over sine is cotangent, so all in all, on the bottom, we really just have negative 2. Cotangent x. And keep in mind, this is on the bottom. Cotangent x on the bottom, we can put that to the top and becomes what? Tangent. So have a look. This becomes negative 2 on the bottom. Let's put it to the front. We have negative 1 half. And the integral tangent right here, x times 1 plus 2 ln of secant x and then to the pi's power. Aha! Can we really solve this? Yes, of course, because I make this. Check this out. I'm going to take a very nice use up. Put it to be the inside. Let u equal to 1 plus 2 ln of secant x. Differentiate both sides. du is equal to, that's going to be 0. We have 2. Derivative of ln is 1 over that. And then the derivative of secant is secant x times tangent x. And you see this and that cancel out very nicely. So in fact, du is just 2 tangent x dx. All right, if you would like, you can put a 2 right here and then again divide it by 2. So you can replace this right here and that together with the du. So altogether in the front, we have negative 1 over 4. And then we have the integral. This is just our u, yeah, to the pi's power. And then this and that altogether is our du. Told you it's not so bad. Now, u to the pi's power, pi is just a nice innocent number, 3.1415. It actually never goes, it never ends, so it's not so nice. It's irrational. But it's just a number, we can use the reverse power rule. So go ahead and add 1 to it and then divide it by that, right? So we will have this. Negative 1 over 4 times pi plus 1 times u, which is that, 1 plus 2 ln of secant x, like so, and then raised to the pi plus 1 power. And we're done, look, plus c, yay. It's not so bad. Everybody's here, sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. I love this one so much. Before we go, let me tell you about our sponsor today, Brilliant.org. Brilliant is an online learning platform with thousands of interactive lessons in math, science, and computer science. And since you are already watching my videos, then I know you like calculus, and let me tell you, Brilliant makes it even better. Their calculus lessons are interactive, so you are not just going to memorize the formulas, but instead, you will be learning the concepts and the ideas via their animations and storytelling. As a calculus teacher, students often ask me how they can learn calculus on their own in a fun way, and I will always recommend Brilliant to them. With a 30-day free trial, you can even get started today, and if you use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen, and you can get 20% off discount. I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video, and also want to thank you guys for checking them out. Boom.